जाने समझे ज्ञान वास्तु शास्त्र का पृथ्वी अग्नि जल वायु स्थान आकाश का
ओम वास्तु पुरुषाय नमो नमः
खुद ही समझो खुद ही जानो कहता है क्या भला
सो There is a lady who is a choreographer, and this lady actually gives you, helps you to actually act on the dance form. And there's a heroine of a movie who actually performs on the in the film. Now the actress in the film makes multi crore rupees, but the choreographer does not make money. She gets paid by day. That okay, you come and help the choreography, you do the choreography, you will be paid by day. So she is in such a situation that she is only paid by day.
Okay.
However, it is she who gives those dance forms.
So I mean someone else is doing the hard work and someone else is doing the hard work,
but who makes money? Money is made by somebody
Southwest.
Who lives here.
Southwest. Okay. Yes.
So the fight master or a dummy in a movie, the dummy of the hero who does the actions is actually here. He does all the hard work, he takes the rest, he sits in the car and takes a flight from this of 10 cars, he takes the risk of his life. But who makes the name? Somebody who sits here. It's the hero who makes the name. People can see that the hero did that action. Actually, the hero did not do the action. It was the dummy who did the action.
The action, yes.
So these are those people, right?
Okay.
And somebody who lives here is good for nothing. Believe me, anybody who goes into Northeast room is good for nothing. We say anybody who has gone to the Northeast area is gone forever. He is good for nothing. So this is a room of creativity, right? But to encash that creativity, you have to occupy the Southwest room also. Have I answered your question, Shivani?
Yes, probably.
You got me?
Yes.
So this is a room of creativity, but it is creativity because of the moon. Let us talk about the air part here, the element of air. Air is not at all stable. Air is never static. Air is always moving. So what you do is, supposingly, this is your shop, right? This is your shop and this is the entry of your shop. Now you have got your cash counter over here in the Southwest. Like I said, you must have your cash counter in the Southwest. You must have your, and this is your display. This happens to be your door. This is your display here, right? There are racks and you have displayed your products. Now supposingly you are into electronic gadgets, right? You are into mobile phones, you are into television, you are into laundry machine, you are into so many things. For example, you are into mobile phones. Now what do you make out of mobile phone? There's a lot of competition in mobile phones. So when you sell a mobile phone worth say $1,000, you actually make only $20 out of it, right? Because there's a lot of competition and these companies, they spend a lot of money on advertisement. So to the retailer or to the dealer, they don't give enough margins because they say that in any case, we spend a lot of money on advertisement and marketing, so we cannot give you so much profits. So on $1,000, he makes only $20. But then the dealer says, where do I make my money from? So the company says, you make your money from the accessories, because the accessories are only $50, $90 and $100 or maybe $20. So people are not going to watch this small figure. People are going to watch this figure. So out of the sale of $1,000, he makes only $20. But when he sells a phone charger for $50, he makes $30 out of that, right? So now the shopkeeper realizes that I make more money from the accessories than I make money from the phones. Okay, So what he does is, what he should be doing is, northwest corner, anything that comes into this corner must go. Again, I'm repeating, anything that comes in northwest corner must go. That is a rule.
Because of the air element.
Because the air is going to take away, as and when the air will move, air is going to take away whatever is here. So, now it is you as a shopkeeper, you must know that what I am supposed to keep here. So, any product in your shop that gives you more margin are supposed to be kept from here to here. Because if this sells, you make more money. If phone sell, you don't make more money. So if you're going to put your phones here and you get only $20 on a phone,
there's no point.
Then even if you do a lot of turnover, a lot of money comes into your shop, but the margins are very low. But if you keep phones somewhere here, the phones will go, but and the accessories will also go. Accessories, the business turnover will be less, but your margins are big, your profits are big. So this is where you keep your things. You get my point? Supposingly you are a florist and you are selling flowers, you are selling bouquets, you are selling some liquor also, and you are selling some XYZ things in your shop, in your florist shop. You must make sure that all the running items should be kept here. Any dead stock, supposingly there's a flower here in the magnet and you have put it for 5 days, and if it doesn't go in 2 days or 3 days, this flower is going to get spoiled. This flower is going to lose its charm. So what you do is you immediately realize that, oh, for 5 days this flower is not gone, this bouquet is not gone. Immediately bring and put it here.
Northwest.
In the northwest, so that it goes. Because if it has a charm, it has a smell, and it is fresh, it must go right away before it loses its freshness. So this is an information that northwest means air, air means mobility, mobility means it must go. So anything you like in industry, like when we go to industries, they tell us, Mr. Gyani, we have a problem. I say, why have you called me? So they'll say, well, we have a problem that we have very good quality of work product, but our product will not sell, and we don't understand why it doesn't sell. We take so much care to achieve the best of the quality and also the pricing. So our management is good, everything is good, but something is wrong and my product will not go. So we say, look, see my dear, what has happened is that you have kept your finished products in the northeast corner. And northeast corner means attachment. And the northwest corner means detachment. So this is detachment, right? So the moment you keep your finished product in the northeast corner, though it is a good quality, it does not move. So what you need to do is, whatever is here, bring it here, and all this finished product should be brought here. Once the finished product comes into the air area, the air is going to make sure that it will lift it. It will lift it and the material will go. So the finished product in industries should always be into
northwest corner.
Northwest. And the dispatches should also be from the northwest. Right. It can be from here. It can be from here. It can be from north of northwest. It can be from west of northwest. Doesn't really matter. Both the doors are good for dispatches. So there has to be a cycle. Supposingly you take your raw material from here, you put it here, you take action one, machine two, machine three. The flow chart has to be like this. But it has to be clockwise.
It should end
so
at
the raw
northwest.
Material comes in here, process one, process two, process three, process four, packing, dispatches, gone. Right, this is the process. This is a very good flow chart for industries. So if you happen to have this flow chart, you're lucky. If you don't have, you have to make it like this. If you cannot, doesn't really matter. Whenever somebody is making a factory or industry, he must make sure that this should be my flow chart, and this is a wonderful flow chart. Nothing can go wrong with this industry if such an industry has a flow chart like this. So northwest means heart, creativity. Air means dispatches. Air means deliveries. Air means must go. So now what do you do? Supposingly in your office you have somebody who is a very mischievous character, and he is not working to favor the organization, rather he is working against the organization. But he is a very key person and he cannot be thrown out of the organization. As a result, what do? You very very nicely, you tell him, okay, Mr. So-and-so, from today, you are going to sit in this direction in the northwest. We have made a cabin for you and please sit here. So what happens is, you just wait and watch. 6 months down the line, this guy is going to say, well, I got another job and I'm leaving the organization and I'm going. You didn't have to do anything. He left by himself. Actually, the air took him away. So the notorious guy, who was a pain in the neck and you could not remove him for whatever the reason, has gone by himself, just because you tactically you managed it some way
smartly,
with a belief that let me put him into the northwest corner and he's going to go because Mr. Gyani has said so and he will be gone. You get my point? Now supposedly you have an office and you have got various departments, and the various departments are production. So you have production, you have finance, accounts, you have the director, then you have purchase, then you have marketing, and you have got administration. There are 6 departments in your big office or in your factory. Now, supposedly, for example, you put these marketing guys into the northeast corner, okay? And you put administration here. Now, there is everything wrong about the marketing department. Why?
Because
you want the marketing people into the market on the streets. But because you put them into the magnet, they say, okay, we are going, yeah, at 2 I'm going to the market. At 2 you see him in the office. Hey, you didn't go to the office. Yeah, there's somebody coming in, I'm having a meeting with him. At 3:30 I'm going to the market. He will never go to the market. The attachment of this corner is not going to allow him to leave the office. And somebody who is required in the market on the streets is sitting in the office. So what do? We have an information that air means moving, so we put all our salesmen, all our marketing guys into this corner. Where? Into the northwest. Because we don't want them to be in the office. They are required in the office for just 20-30 minutes in the morning, and they can come back in the evening and report for 20-30 minutes. Rest of the time they should be in the market. So what you do is, all the marketing guys, put them into northwest corner, because once they are in the northwest corner, what will happen is
they will move.
They will not. This room will not allow them to sit in here. This room will throw them out. Go, and they'll be gone. Right. So if you have 3 directors, 1 active director, 2 active director, 3 sleeping director, you will invariably see that the sleeping director will always have his room in the northwest corner. Why? Oh, he's a sleeping director. He comes once in a month. He comes for 2 hours once in a month and has his coffee and chats with us and he goes away. Well, invariably he'll be in the northwest corner because he's somebody who is not coming to the office regularly. So the company is going to give him, without knowledge, company is going to give him the northwest room. And if there is an active director who happens to have this room, he will be flying from place to place to place for getting orders, for collecting money, or for development, R&D, whatever, for the growth of the company. But he is somebody who is not sitting in the office because he has a job that makes him travel a lot for orders, for payments.
He will not be at a fixed place. Yeah. It will be variable.
Because he is in northwest corner. So this corner does not allow this director to sit in the office at peace. The moment he comes, next day he's flying somewhere. The moment he comes back, again he's flying somewhere. Again he comes back, again he's going somewhere. So, northwest corner directors do not generally sit in their offices. They cannot. So this is about it. You can have your kitchen here, like I say, northwest is air and southeast is fire. And fire is nothing without air, without oxygen. You cannot blow a fire without oxygen. So fire and oxygen, fire and air are friends. So when the fire comes here, fire has no problem because fire is visiting a friend.
They
right?
are in harmony.
So the only thing is, when you have your kitchen in the northwest corner, you make sure that it is west facing. And when you have your kitchen in the southeast corner, you make sure that it is east facing. So the south, in the southeast corner and east facing kitchen is the best. In the northwest corner, west facing kitchen is the best. Do not go by the thumb rule of east, face east while cooking. No, there's no such rule. It says it is a combination. So if there's a fire here, there is going to be cross ventilation, right? And so that you can run from here. So in the southeast, the kitchen is allowed, and in the northeast, the kitchen, northwest, the kitchen is allowed. You can have your storeroom here. A storeroom here means food here. So the food must go. The air will take over the food. The food must go. So to for the food to go means you must have a lot of guests coming in. Only then the food will be used. And more the guests, more the merrier. More the guest, more the merrier. Guests will go to only such place where there is richness. Yes. A guest will not go to a poor man's house. A guest will always go to a rich man's house. So the fact that more guests are coming to you means you are rich. And the fact that your storeroom is in the northwest again is an indicator of richness. It is directly or indirectly an indicator of richness, because you are rich and therefore the guests are coming to you. So a storeroom is allowed in the northwest corner. However, because this is a corner of mother, let me tell you that a dismemberment of this corner results into something, a very weird situation. For example, that this is your house, like this, or maybe like this. If the northwest corner is dismembered, that means your relationship with your mother, moon is mother,
is cut.
The relationship with your mother is going to be very weird, in the sense that you are staying here, your mother is in this room, this is your mother, and this is you. And you are the best son possible on this earth. Why? Because you are taking care of your mother. You go to her room and ask your mom, "Mama, have you taken your medicines? Do you have enough stock of medicines? Are you feeling good? Do you need to see to a doctor? Did you have proper breakfast today? Please tell me, what did you have in your breakfast? And what are you going to have in your lunch? Or is there any specific thing that you would like to have in your lunch? Do you have enough juices in your refrigerator? Enough milk, enough things that you like? X, Y, Z." Every morning I must ask these questions to my mom, and also tell her, "Do you need an appointment with the doctor? Shall I take an appointment with the doctor?" So she says, "Yes, I'm not feeling well. I would like to see a doctor." So I say, "Okay, Mama, I will fix an appointment with the doctor and make sure that everything is arranged."
A caring attitude, concerned.
Very concerning, very concerning.
Agni.